is Charlie Sorter, survival.com, and I'm doing my last series of field expedient loading of shotgun shells and ammo. Today we're going to talk about making a permanent system for your bug out bag, your survival bag, whichever you want to use, but we're going to be using the brass, full brass shells, 12 gauge shotgun. And I'll show you how you can incorporate this into your survival situation and your urban survival situation, whatever situation you might be in, surviving out in the wilderness, what have you. But we're going to go ahead and discuss this as part of your gear and field expedient loading of this the shell here. So let me get prepared. We'll be right back. Okay, we're back. If you have seen my other two posts on field expedient reload of ammo for a shotgun, then you'll catch up on a lot of stuff we're going to cover now, because a lot of it I'm not going to cover. Basically, what we're going to talk about is incorporating brass ammo into your bug out bag, survival bag, or what have you. I'm going to be using the MagTech brass shot shell. I believe I got this off of Midway, off the internet. It's probably about between $24 and $26 a box of 25. I bought two boxes of it because these things will last a long time. Basically, the way I'm going to do is I'm going to have a little setup where I have a total of 7 reusable 12 gauge ammo here, and I'm going to show you how to modify them as well, because your regular 12 gauge shotgun shells and 20 gauge 410s or whatever, you use the 209 primers. Versus this uses the large pistol primers. But I want to show you how you can modify this to take a 209 primer, because they are a whole lot cheaper than the large pistol primers. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to keep 3 of these shells with the large pistol primer setup, and 4 of them I'm going to modify later on for my kit to take the 209. That way I have versatility of 2 different primers. And not to mention that on my other videos you'll see on my sortofsurvival.com website, as well as my YouTube channel, I show you how to take and actually, once you pop that primer out, how to take the primer apart and reprime that to be reused. So never, when you shoot these, keep the primers, keep the shells, because you can use them or reuse them in a field expedient emergency situations. So let's go ahead and, once you've viewed my other videos, you'll see what tools I had in my little kit. I have a box. This is going to be the box I'm going to use. Once I transport these, they're not going to be loaded. The only thing they're going to be is primed and ready to field load. I'm not going to keep them in a loaded situation, because the way they get loaded, they get bounced around, they may come apart on you or not shoot very well. So I'm going to keep them in this state until this state, with them primed, pre-primed and ready to go when I get ready to field load those. So my kit, of course, you're going to need your powder. I'm using number 7.5 shot. I'm using Pyrodex rifle and shotgun powder. I have my materials for my overshot cards. You can see that in my other post. I have my material for my powder wad. I have my little block for cutting the wads with. My little metal thing there for pounding on. Of course, my primer removal tools. We won't need those, because I won't be removing the primers. But I will need my powder temper. I'll need my wad cutter for 12 gauge. I'll need my homemade powder and shop measuring tool. I'll need my 12 gauge primer crimping tool. I'm going to also show you how you can do this using a deep well socket and a C-clamp to set your primers. But there are other techniques where you can actually tamp on the primer on a hard surface without making it go off, and that'll help set your primer for you. We'll need the glue stick, the lighter again. What else do I need out of this kit? That's all I'm going to need out of that kit right there. I have my little 2x4 I'm using for a hammer to help keep the sparks from flying around. And of course, for this, you're going to need a 15/16 drill bit and a drill. I'm going to actually load two different shells, and we're going to go out and test fire those shells after we reload them up. Okay, first one I'm going to load, we're going to use the large pistol primers. Basically, all that is, I'll show you the difference here for those that don't know. You notice how a 209 primer has a sleeve and the cap. A large pistol primer only has the prime cap, which is the silver part inside this primer. So basically, the primer well, or the cap well, whatever you want to call it, is one unit versus the cap well for this is already built into the bottom of the shell. So let's load this one first, and then we'll go on to using the 209 for the second one, which we're going to have to modify. So basically, checking the shell, make sure there's no bends, dents, cracks, everything's in round. You want to take, sometimes it's easy to take it and lay it flat on a surface and then try stabbing it that way. If you're like me, I'm clumsy. But let's do it this way. A pair of tweezers will probably help out, but set it in there as flat as you can get it, because you're not going to be able to hand press that in there. Okay, this technique here, I'm going to be using my crimping tool. Once I get it seated, let's try that. See if that's going to work out for me any better. Okay. Haha, success. Okay. It's sitting there. Wasn't easy. Because you gotta get them really flat on there, because if they're a little bent, cockeyed, they're not gonna go in right. So this one's ready to load. So this is a will fit 2 3/4 chambered shotgun 12 gauge, and as well as a 3-inch. So we're going to be using my powder measurement for the 2 3/4 that I have measured on my bottle. Let's go with the powder first. I'm going to be doing this kind of fast, not really explaining a lot of it, because like I say, I don't want to, if you go watch my other videos on it, I'll explain measuring out your powder and all that kind of stuff. All right, powder goes in. Powder tamps down slightly. Okay, powder's in there. Now I got my side of here measured for the wads that I need. This is going to be, I'm going to need one more of these cut. So let me put my shell aside so I don't spill it. And let's cut another wad. This is the wad cutter, also overshot card cutter. Basically, you just put it on there. Yeah. Okay. Material I'm using for my wads. If you don't have your plastic wads to go down in there for your powder, I'm using the felt saddle blanket. It's the saddle blanket that goes out underneath the saddle for your riding horses. It's makes pretty good wadding material. I'm gonna need two of those for this shell. Place them in there, compress it down. Okay. Next, I need to measure out my shot, the amount of shot I'm gonna be using, number 7.5. Okay, I went over line just a little bit, but that's okay, because once I get in here, I don't know how much take out if it doesn't go over. Okay. I'm only using this amount of shot in there for this. Doesn't need to be very much. It doesn't have to go all the way to the top or anything. Next, you're gonna need set that aside so it'll fall off on me. I'm gonna need, I like to use two overshot cards, so I'm gonna go ahead and pound out two of them here. And let me put my top on my shot there so it doesn't go flying over the place. Okay. There's one. These tools I'm using are antique, so the cutter's a little bit dull. Not as sharp as a brand new one, but it works. You just got to work with it. Okay. There's my shot card, overshot card. Bring my shell back out. Let me take one shot card, place that in there. Down a little bit. Place that aside. Get your glue stick and your lighter. Heat up the glue. Okay, put it inside so that it covers the shot card and the rim of the shell. I always use two shot cards because when I do that, it helps push the glue, forces the glue even further out against the well, the side walls of the shot. Just clean it off, and that's ready to fire. Now, let's talk about modifying this for use with the 209 primer. Let me go ahead and remove this primer here that was giving me a bugger of a time. Okay. So basically what you're going to need for this is a drill. That's why you need to pre-do this before you go out in the field, because you're not going to probably have access to a drill out there. And you're going to need a 15/16 drill bit. Basically what I do is, you can probably put this in a soft vise or some kind. But if you're careful, you can do it by hand. Just drill out the center of that primer well. Alright. I may fast forward through this a little bit to spare you the boredom of me drilling. But anyway, the hole's drilled out to 15/16, which should take the 209 primer. See? You're not going to be able to push it in all the way because it's supposed to be a little snug. The only drawback is that there is no recess lip in there for this ring. No recess in this for this ring set down in there, but that's okay. It's not going to hurt anything. So let me show you how to apply the primer to this using the deep well socket and the C-clamp in the event you don't have one of these primer crimp tools. That way if you have this, you can do the primers on 410s, 20 gauge, 16 gauge, 10 gauge. I'm just going to open this all the way up so I know it's going to be there when it needs it. Get a deep well socket to where it'll fit inside here and will also allow the primer to go down through the center there. Seems almost too small. Luckily there's a little cup in the other side of this that it'll fit in, because this thing's almost the exact size. You can also take and do something like this, put a piece of wood over that, and then hit it down like this, and it'll seat the primer as well. As long as you're not pounding the heck out of it, the primer shouldn't go off. But so that's the second way. But let me show you, continue on doing the way I was doing it. May need to get a little bit bigger C-clamp. Get this thing started. There you go. So now basically you just get in the video there. Take this and keep going until it seats in there. Turn it over a little bit since it's already got past the point I need it. Come on, you. Okay. Alright. Show you the primers appear. Primer's on this side, so you just keep holding it in the center there. Keep twisting it down. There you go. Seats the primer for you. Or again, like I said, you can put it on a surface like this. Take it. Tap it. Make make sure it's tamped all the way. All right, that looks good. So there's three ideas you just saw on putting your primer in. So let's go ahead and load this up like we did the other one. So we can go out and test fire it. It's going to be for small shot. Okay, powder. Go kind of fast now since I don't want this video to be too long. It takes a long time to upload them. Tamp the powder down. Put it to the side so just tip over while I'm cutting my wad materials. I'm going to need two of these wads. Ooh, my wife see me doing this, she's going to whoop me. What you can do, you can make a bunch of these ahead of time and put them in your kit so you won't have to do this out in the field. Which is what I'm going to do. There you go. Okay. There's my... two wads. Bring the shell back. One wad, two wads, press down firmly, nice and seated. Okay, next is going to be the shot. There's where I want the shot. I'm not putting a lot of shot in here since I'm just test firing them. No use in wasting them, wasting the shot. Go ahead and tamp that down a little bit. Make sure it's seated nice and good. Put that to the side. Gonna need my overshot cards now. I have enough to make just two more. Kind of fast, trying to do this. It doesn't take long to load these once you get rolling on it. Okay, overshot card. Tamp her down. Get away from the fire, get your glue stick going. You can, for this part here, you can use wax, tallow, pine glue, anything of that nature if you don't have a glue stick. Okay, cover all the walls in there. Put my second shot card to seal it better. Just like that. Remove the excess. And we have two ready to go. One with the large pistol primer, one with the modified 209 primer. So let's stop the video, go set up my firing range, and we'll test fire these bad boys. Okay, I'm hoping to, this is a video, it's hard to see the camera, okay. First one we're going to shoot is
assembly that I put together with the large pistol primer. You see, let's go ahead and test fire that. We're going to be shooting on that box there. I'm just trying to see if I can get everything in the picture. Here we go. Perfect. Pops out like it's supposed to. Put that aside. Now we're gonna do the one that we modified using the 209 primer. Drop down the dirt, you gotta clean it up again. Okay, I see what I'm gonna go ahead and show this on. I didn't try doing this before doing it, but with this, it's not allowing the gun to lock. Reason being, because there's a lip there. The ring of this primer needs to be seated down, kind of like this one is, so it's flush. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to redesign this to where I'm going to get a bigger drill bit and go, and so make a little recess so that the rim of this primer will sit flush with this, and then retry, because it's not allowing this to reseat. So, lesson learned on that one. I like to add my mistakes on the video so you can see things that you run into. So, I'm not going to conclude this one until I get this set up to work. So, bear with me. Okay, I'm back. We can finish this up. Took this back, redesigned it. Basically, what I had to do, once you drill that first hole, you need to take a larger drill bit, in this case was a 23/64, and drill a little recess so that the ring, the lip of that primer cap there, can sit down into that recess so that you have a flat surface across here, as flat as possible. I know it's going to work because I put it in a shotgun and it goes in and it's ready to go. So, second take two on firing of the 12 gauge brass shell converted from large pistol primer to 209 shotgun primers. Let's take and see how that does. Make sure you clean all the glue out. Okay, goes in there. Nice, smooth, locks. Got my safety glasses on and I'm ready to go. So let's give it a test. There you go. Comes out just like it's supposed to. That there could be reused again. That would have been that would have been really ugly if we did this, put it in our emergency kit without putting a little recess in there. Took it to the field and we needed an emergency situation and load them up, couldn't find out they wouldn't fit in the barrel. Ooh, that would have been ugly. Well, lesson learned. I'm glad it's a lesson we all get to see together. I must not have been paying attention when I was watching somebody else try to do this. But anyway, here's a setup, permanent setup for your bug out bag survival kit. It's up to you how many of these shells you want to carry, along with your set. Watch my other two videos on loading these shells. You'll learn how to reload the primers as well. It'll be on my YouTube channel. You can find them there, and it'll also be on my swordofsurvival.com site. So this is Charlie. Stay prepared, stay alive, come back soon. Thank you.